Welcome back, everybody. This is Coda here from Vortex Logistics. And one second, I forgot to put that under the game. There we go. And we are back in Viper 2's 389. We did some modification here. So, of course, we still got pretty much the same base truck. But yeah, we are driving the come apart tonight, or otherwise what is known as a Cummins. We've got the N14, 605 horsepower underneath the hood. We've got an 18-speed Eaton Fuller transmission under the hood. Our first load today is taking us to Las Vegas. We are here at the Port of Oakland. So let's hop in and get going. Gary, how's it going? Welcome to the stream this evening. Okay, and again, four-wheelers really need to learn how to drive. And no, you are not seeing anything out of the mirrors. That is a pumpkin wagon that I've got on the back. Definitely good to see you again, that's for sure. Yes, I am pulling double duty today, Zach. swapped out engines to a coma part, or for those who are not keen on that lingo, that means a Cummins engine. Oh, I know about that. I took a, I wasn't driving, but I took a trip down to DC on Saturday, and oh my god, it was insane. Give me one moment here. I swore I put Nightbot into being ignored, but apparently ScottyBot is not listening, so I've got to fix that. Alright, I guess apparently I'm not able to do that. That mixer is going to keep showing that. One second here, I gotta get a quick command here for ScottyBot. Okay, we're not gonna have that problem anymore. Well, the funny thing is, most of them don't realize that a lot of the truck drivers do run dash cams these days, so I'm guessing they're trying to do it for insurance, to try to get out of working or to basically sue, and when they find out the truckers have a dash cam, yeah, that so doesn't work very well. ago, no more snap talk from ScottyBot for Nightbot posting my donation link. And just like earlier, guys, that donation link is there to if you would like to help with PC upgrades, but it is not a requirement. Actually, Cummins, they are good. Just truck drivers call them come apart. Apparently, some of them did have problems back in the day. Oh, exactly. That is exactly it. CD Gamer, hey, how's it going? Long time no see. Welcome to the stream.
All right.
And CD Gamer, thank you so much for that subscribe. I've got to tell Iron Man that he spent about another $75,000 in upgrades for the truck. Oops. Definitely for the cats. When I drove back in the day, that's all I drove underneath the hoods were cats. Didn't have a Detroit, never drove a Cummins underneath there either. The only complaints I hear out of truckers these days is more about the Volvo engines than anything else. mean, you don't hear them complaining about Detroit's, Cummins, Cats, or even the Mack engines. It's all Volvo. Logbooks? Nah, I never ran those. I ran comic books. Disloyal Box, hey, how's it going? Welcome to the stream this evening. Mostly what I drove transmission-wise back in my day were 9s and 10s, and I did drive a 13. Never drove a 15 or an 18 until I got the game, so basically it's pretty much the same thing, it's just where you can split the gears at. Detroits were known back in the day for literally eating oil. We've got some household appliances, 25,500 pounds, or what some people might call dispatcher brains. Now, back when I was driving, I actually drove one of the, I actually drove a Volvo at the time, and that's the one that had the 13-speed in it. And for some odd reason, the driver that was in that truck before me ripped the transmission out of that truck twice. And it's like, if you don't know what the hell you're doing, yes, you're going to rip a transmission out, but to do it twice, that's a little bit uncalled for. It's 1999, and down in the video description on my Mixer channel there should be a link to the Steam store for it. Just sad, pretty much, to rip a transmission out of a truck. I mean, I still don't know how anyone could do it unless they had absolutely no idea, literally, and how they even got their CDL if they ripped a transmission out of the truck is beyond me. Mr. Iron Man, how's it going? Sorry, going through. Now, I actually had to do that one time. That wasn't a hill, but I was going down probably about a 8% grade, and there was a traffic light at the bottom of the grade. And I had a load of 42,000 pounds worth of steel pipe on the back of me. There was no way that I was going to be stopping at the bottom going down that hill. So literally, I just got on the air horn, tried to slow down as much as I can, and thank goodness people knew about that, because I did end up going through the traffic light, but no one moved. Hey King, good to see you again, and say hello to your dad for me also. Thank you. did some modifications to this Pete Iron Man. It cost about $75,000. Hope you don't mind. I was actually pulling out of U.S. Foundry, I believe is what the company was called, in New Jersey. U.S. Pipe and Foundry, that's what it was. Yeah, I kind of extended the chassis from a normal 6x4 to a 6x4 long. So, yeah, it changed out the headache rack and a couple of other things. Remove DP's traffic mod also, so hopefully we should have no more trucks doing 20 miles an hour or AI that just stops right in front of you. I saw that truck on the mod sites earlier today. A little more screen real estate for you guys also. I did get a mirror mod that puts the mirrors up in the corner instead of right down, so you guys should definitely be able to see a little bit better. I do have a flatbed trailer mod. I just don't have it installed right now. It's the Fruhoff Phantom trailers that I do have the mod for. Not the Fruhoff, Fontaine, I'm sorry. Here, maybe my brother might get off his Xbox and come up and want to drive, and it's like, okay, you got to drive, but I'm streaming, and we're gonna let him go at it. I just had one that moved the mirrors up to the corners, and then they're just a little bit smaller from what they were. only thing that's missing from this truck now are the bumper guides. I did have them in a light pack, but now they do not show up. And I am not sure why. Xbox One. Oh, it'd be funny as hell if he did. No, he's part of the Grind Brothers, because that's all he does is grind gears. Yeah, that is a mod for the truck, actually. I was thinking about putting brass knuckles on it, but then I said, nah. Even in the cheating overhead view, I cannot back up. Ah. This truck just doesn't turn worth a damn. I forgot I lengthened it. Okay, I guess I did bump the dock. Michael Gaming 300, hey, how's it going? Because everybody runs the twin sticks. Yeah, I built this truck for heavy hauling, so yeah, let's grab ourselves a heavy haul. That's if there's any here. Wow, not one single heavy haul. That's right, we're gonna take some wiggle wagons. And you didn't bring any for me? Blow the horn there at Dimitri. I would love to, Iron Man. What was it that I was reading? That Southwest cut airline ticket, airline prices again? I think some round trips are underneath $100 now. Thank you. Dropping hooks are way too easy. Now you gotta go into a Walmart DC to where they have to break apart the whole trailer, and it takes you 8 hours to get unloaded. No, that's what you pay a lumper for. So long, Dimitri. Yeah, I don't understand why they have to break down pallets as they pull them off. I mean, they've got to get the drivers in and out. They shouldn't be sitting on a dock for 8 hours waiting for Walmart to break down the load to their specifications. That's just stupid. Oh, I get you there, Zach. I mean, there's times when my brother was driving for Trans Am, I was actually went out with him on the road for a couple of weeks, and out of the loads that we delivered, only two of them were drop and hook. Everything else was a live unload, And at the time, pretty much in order to keep myself living on the road so he didn't have to pay for everything, I helped him lump off the loads and I got the money for it. Welcome back, Mr. Iron Man. Yeah, the last time it was Zach with pasta and barbecue ribs, if I remember. I did drive some, as a matter of fact, but most of the time I was sitting in the passenger seat, and I was between jobs at the time, still had my CDL, so no big deal. Anyway, I'm just glad that we didn't get caught. It was mostly when I drove, it was the middle of the night, and not being hired by the company and or insurance or anything like that, it would have been quite the explanation. Some protests going on about that last week too, to where about detention pay, lumpers, and also the ELDs or electronic driver logs. And I don't know why they're bitching about ELDs. If you're stuck in traffic and you're sitting behind the wheel, sorry, but you are still driving. Right, give FedRex the green light to bypass. Woot, woot! Oh, I know my brother reads that. I mean, granted, yes, you're not making money unless you're moving, but you cannot control what traffic is going to be like that day. You've got 11 hours of drive time. I mean, if you're stuck in traffic for 10 of those, too bad. That's when you call your company and you start bitching. I mean, there are laws there for a reason, and that's to protect you, the driver, and all the other people on the road. NHL 18. I actually beat him a couple of the games that we've played. I've worked for a beer distributor. I know all about that. Literally, no matter where you went, you had to rotate all the stock so the stuff that you were taking in was going to be the last out. Just once I want to blow a tire with one of these four-wheelers sitting beside me, but yet won't ever happen. you guys are liking the video today, make sure you give it a thumbs up and let me know. If you're not already subscribed, please do so. You'll be notified the next time I am streaming live. Well, isn't that what you're supposed to do with recaps, is throw them at the four-wheelers? Literally, it's crazy the amount of companies that will use recaps on the drives, all just to save $100 to $150 per tire. It's like, really? You're gonna put your driver's safety at risk and use recaps that you know are just gonna fly apart? Must be an old lady in that four-wheeler. I should have went around him. And yes, I totally forgot how to downshift because I'm grinding gears left and right. Oh, I've had bits and pieces of alligators thrown up into the grill on my car. Yeah, that makes a nice little clunk. Mr. Krabs is a good analogy there, Iron Man. please have some heavy hulls here? There we go, we're gonna take a transformer up to Big Smoky, Nevada. Everything is your fault, Iron Man. You're the company owner. Yep, and I'm even having trouble upshifting today, too. Yep, so that's why we blame you for everything. Well, it's only fair. Alright, where'd they put my trailer? Are you kidding me? I'm not gonna be able to get back into that thing. And whose dang bright idea was to put a transformer back here? Thank you. think I'm going to be able to hook onto this, but we're definitely going to try. Just for this load, I'm going to have to turn that off because there's going to be no way to get it. And the lumper cost you that much money? Holy moly! Oh, I'm sure lumpers, I mean, they literally just rigged the companies if they pay for them. There's no way it would cost $400 or $500 just to pull a load off of a trailer that's all pallets. That's just unbelievable. That's a good one, Zach. Woo! Made it! Close only counts in horseshoes, hand grenades, and nuclear warfare. Even with a 600 horsepower engine with 2700 newton meters of torque, this transformer is heavy. I've got a Core i5 6400 in here. What I wanted to update to was, which is, you'll see the donation down there for the PC upgrades. I would either want to get the Ryzen 1600X and along with an X370 motherboard, so of course have all the features for overclocking and whatnot, or the Core i7-8600K along with a Z370. I mean, either way, that donation is there if you guys want to help out. Otherwise, the upgrades are going to be coming. I will pay for them out of my own pocket. this be a little bit of an overkill, Zach? Kenworth, how's it going? I have a GTX 970. Don't think you can do that. Let me guess, when you're stepping on the accelerator, your front end comes off the ground? If he uses Transformers, Zach, I would hate to see your electric bill. Oh, the Coca-Cola is actually quite steep, and, I'm not sure. Were you running Canada Dream by chance? Thing I can think of is if you were using a modded truck, try to do an 8x4. I think the show was canceled, but Jamie Davis, Highway Through Hell, when that was playing on the Weather Channel, it still does every now and then. I used to sit and watch that for hours on end. Heavy was the load. Yeah, that's a little bit heavy. Was it on a like a low boy, or what kind of trailer was it on? I don't, as a matter of fact. Well, I have a Discord, but I don't have it set up for the moment. If you want to add me, my number is 5229. This is one long-ass vehicle, though. with the trailer itself, Kenworth, the only thing I can think of is, I mean, just like real life, there was too much weight on the nose, so it put a whole bunch of weight onto your drive axles and actually caused the front of your truck to come up off the ground. And I don't know if they do a like a weight distribution in these trailers or not. I'm just not that technical. I've done that myself plenty of times. Gaming. Hey, how's it going? Welcome to the stream this evening. Glad you could join us. And totally agreed. Man, that's definitely enough axles, so I would have no idea why the front of your truck would be coming off the road. Directly from Steam. There is a link down in the video description to the Steam store for the game. Last price that I know, it is $19.99. Also linked in the video description is the gear that I'm using, the Thrustmaster T150 wheel, the T3 PA pedals, TH8A shifter, and sitting on top of that shifter is the Mega Shifter from Tech Affliction, which is a real world shift knob that's been converted for PC use. Not a problem at all. If you wanted to try the game out, there is a free demo out there available also. Just go to the Steam store, search for American Truck Simulator. You would be able to run around Arizona for free as a demo to make sure that you do like it before you buy it. Thank you. Oh, not a problem at all. That's how I started, actually. I ran around Arizona for a couple of days, bought the game on sale on Thanksgiving last year, and literally have gotten addicted. I started out running with a keyboard, and literally about 2 to 3 weeks later, I had my wheel pedals and ran that for a while, and then I got the shifter and the shift knob. And just so you know, a shifter is not required. All the trucks can be run as an automatic. Oh, you're welcome, pirate. geez, Coda. Oh, cool, they're gonna stop and wait for me. Desktop. I think my physics pack was updated because this truck is starting to bounce around a little bit. Thank you. know this place was so far outside of town. Okay, I'm gonna take the just been hired, unfortunately not trained trailer. This is a modded truck actually, so a lot of the prices are not of what you're going to be paying in the base game. This truck on average though was about $160,000. Gaming, thank you so much for the subscribe. I appreciate it. Notice I brought up the external GPS. You'll see $3.5 billion there. I'm using a mod testing profile basically for my streaming, so I don't have to worry about money or anything. But it does take you a little bit to earn the skill points and the XP that you do need in order to buy your first truck and get something fully updated. Of course, if you wanted to, you can use a money and XP cheat in order for that to happen quicker. Eduardo, hey, how's it going? Welcome to the stream today. Bryoma, hey, how's it going? Welcome to the stream this evening. Definitely glad you could join us. Thank you for that, Bryoma. Thank you. Wilson. Hey, how's it going? Welcome to the stream this evening. Thank you. my goodness. That was absolutely horrible, Coda. AI. Yes, that was an accident right in front of me. yes, that was a legal pass. As long as you start the maneuver before the lines on the road change or whatever, it is considered a legal pass. At least it is in the state where I live, and for California, I really don't know, but I've never gotten pulled over by the police for doing something like that, and I've had one behind me when I did it. I thought I was getting off there. Big old mistake. I am going to call it quits here for the night, guys. I have to be up at 4 o'clock in the morning. So I do want to thank you for liking and for subscribing tonight. If you did enjoy the live stream, make sure you give it a thumbs up and let me know. We will catch you back here on the next stream, which will more than likely be sometime this weekend, more than likely. I do want to hope you have a great rest of your Tuesday night. Thanks for watching. Coda from Vortex Logistics here. We will see you on the flip-flop.